How you doing, broskies? Or female women broskies. I don't know. That's only like 8% of my audience's YouTube. So we're pretty good in the sausage fest category. Yeah. Today we're going over the ASM1 Speakeasy, which is possibly the better or the best version of the ASM1 in the class. By far one of the best SMGs in the game, but the best variation of it. Other ASM1s would include the Rigger, the Reckless, the Strider, the Reliable. Those are the best ones to me in my mind that I can think of off the top of my head. But yeah, let's go over it. I wanted to make a video on how to get the gun because everyone asks me in my chat while I'm streaming, Marksman, how do you get this, how do you get that, which is kind of ridiculous, but I think so far right now there's only one way to get it, and I'm going to go over both ways because they're going to be going to be releasing another way soon. This will help you guys get the gun unlocked if you'd like to go for it. The other way is much more difficult, but keep in mind it's a guaranteed way. So the first is the obvious one, alright? A supply drop. Supply drops give all sorts of weapons, good, bad, awful, and amazing. Usually the best ones are the elite weapons, sometimes they're not. Like in the case of the Atlas, the Snapper is a very good elite version, but an even better version is the Hypersonic, because it doesn't drop your accuracy, but also gives you +2 fire rate. So not every weapon, the elite version has to be the best. A lot of the cases it is, don't get me wrong, but not every time. Anyways, a supply drop is one of the best ways to get the Speakeasy. It is random, so it does take some time, but it's much easier than the alternative. Now, the alternative hasn't been released yet, and I'm going to talk about that. I can't attest, because it hasn't been released, to what the stats or what the requirements are going to be to get it. But I know, for example, to get like the Obsidian Steed, the Baal Obsidian Steed, one of the best Baals in the game, you'll have to get a certain amount of headshots with the Baal, like an X amount. It's a lot, though. I think it's like 5,000 people we're talking about, or 10,000, which is a shitload of headshots. But I think to get the ASM1 Speakeasy, it's probably going to require a similar type of challenge. Either A, amount of headshots, or B, amount of kills. Maybe 5,000 to 10,000 kills with the ASM1, or maybe, you know, 2,500 headshots or something like they used to do in Modern Warfare 2 to unlock the golden titles. If you guys haven't played for that long, then maybe you don't know what I'm talking about. Maybe, oh, is it MW3 or MW2? I think it's, oh, I'm confused. I don't know, one of the two. One of the two. But it was like 2,500 headshots to unlock the title. So they might do that to unlock the best versions of the weapon. This may cause for a lot of boosting in the game, who knows. But it does offer you like a full-fledged, definitely 100% way to unlock the weapon you're looking for. So it is a good thing at the same time. People are like, oh shit, now I can get the weapon I've been wanting to get for so long. I haven't had the luck to get it. And granted, I've been decently lucky. I have just about every elite weapon there is. For good and bad, but you know it doesn't come with like a lot of luck in my opinion. It comes with play time because you just have to play a lot. I have like 9 days something played while I've been streaming and uploading and stuff like that. It just so happens that I've unlocked a lot of guns at this point. I'm still missing a few that I would like the HBRA3 Insanity, but you know that'll come hopefully. Just give it some time, keep pulling open the supply drops and get lucky. At some point I'll get it. That's what I have in my mind. Also though, like I said. Once this new update releases, we'll have a chance to unlock it via headshots or kills. We'll have to see which one they go with and how much it is. I'm not sure if it'll be worth it, but yeah, we'll find out. So those are the two ways that are currently, like, you can unlock the actual gun, the Speakeasy. But I'm going to talk more about that because the Speakeasy itself is a good gun. The only difference, the only benefit it has over a gun like the Magnitude or the Rigger is that its stats are, like, built-in rapid fire. Sorry, I'm, like, stuttering over that word. So when you put rapid fire on an ASM1, it gives you +2 fire rate while -2 accuracy. Now, a cool thing about the Speakeasy is that it gives you +2 fire rate, like you have rapid fire on the gun, but it doesn't lower your accuracy any. So you still have a 6 accuracy with the, I think, 13 fire rate. So that is something that is very rare, because if you take a normal ASM1, and that's with 6 accuracy, 11 fire rate, and you want to raise your fire rate to 13, you're going to have 4 accuracy, so you need a grip to counteract that. So by having the 6 accuracy off the bat, you're able to raise your accuracy up to 8, I believe, and it's even more accurate with rapid fire built in, of course, and you have the extended mags. The extended mags, although it's not super like necessary in S&D, it does help immensely for respawn, so that's why this is one of the best weapons for respawn players. But you can replicate those stats. They won't be able to match them exactly, but you can replicate them. Good weapons for that are the magnitude and the rigor. Pretty much anything that you're going to be using that would include like plus accuracy or plus range, because you usually have advanced rifling, you just don't include that when you put them on the attachments. So, for example, if you have the rigor, you have 8 accuracy with an 11 fire rate. You can put on rapid fire to get 13 fire rate. Then you can put on grip again to get back to an 8 accuracy. So you're matching the speakeasy and stats. And then you can put on extended mags as well, where you won't have the advanced rifling, which kind of sucks. You'd have that on the speakeasy, but you will have everything else the speakeasy has. Or you can put on advanced rifling, and you won't have the extended mags of the speakeasy, but you'll have everything else matched. This might be kind of confusing for you guys, but pay attention to the weapon stats, because that's what will help you realize how the speakeasy is so much better than the regular ASM1s, and how you can kind of replicate its stats with other ASM1 variants. Specifically, though, the magnitude and the rigor. Those two are ones that can match the speakeasy very, very well because of the +2 I have on them. Like, it's +2 to a useful stat. The rigor basically has a built-in grip because of +2 accuracy. So you get away with having higher accuracy, and you can overall make the gun better. But that is it for the video. I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope this has helped you a little bit. This is a 30-plus gameplay that we lost. So if you don't feel bad for me, I don't know what will. This is ridiculous. If you enjoyed, though, leave a like, and I will see you guys later. Thank you for watching, and have a good evening or day wherever you are.
Counting on you.
Oh, fuck yeah.